So what you also got to remember is, so the EP happened before me. So everything up until, so like Inaruin, Cold Night, Serpent, all those things, that was before me. High
Okay.
Fives and Hand Grenades was pre-written. I came in during their studio edits, and then I added a couple things. So that was the first one I was in on.
So who's the longest member? Is Mark the longest member of the band in the band?
It was Randall and I are the only two, I guess, founding
They're
members.
OGs. They're the OGs.
Okay. And
And
what
yeah, I guess I'd be the longest. Technically, I guess I started the band with the original, with another, well, the original guitarist who's no longer here, no longer with us. We actually had to beg and plead with Randall, who at the time was playing in a fucking cover band. And like, I swear to God, it took like 2 months. Like, every day I was hitting him up. I was like, fuck are you doing? Why are you playing these stupid ass covers? Like, come do what you want to do.
Yeah.
He was like, I don't want to bail on these people. And then finally we got him. But yeah, Randall and I are the two, I guess. They were the only originals left out of the original lineup.
And did the original, the main original of all the originals band start in 2017?
Yeah, December. And like Mark said, I was actually I was the guitarist, so.
They're a real guitar player.
And then I moved to bass, and like, so nobody's where they started.
Right, so you guys all kind of, that's interesting to know that you guys have all switched instruments, are doing different. Now, Nick's still new. Nick's tired over there. He's like, I'm fucking tired. I've been like three radio shows today. I'm going to fucking sleep right after this. But I hope you're having a little bit of fun. Dude, all these other shows you guys been on, what's like the main question people ask you?
What'd you
Like the
guys?
main question that people ask us really is where the fuck you got your name from? Or how the fuck your positions became to where they were. Like, and that seems to be recurring,
Yeah,
like, all the time.
but to ask a band named Seasons where they got their name from, to me doesn't even make sense because it's like some deep fucking meaning. It's fucking the weather changes, or you put seasonings on your food, or it just sounds kind of like a cool name. But is there? I don't think I wouldn't think there's a really deep meaning behind it, unless I'm wrong.
I mean, I talked to the, we had an interview right before this one, and like we'll readdress this, but like it's like if your band's Cradle of Filth, it's like, well, that obviously had like there's something behind that. So like we get it all the time, and I'm pretty sure they're like aware of that. And then they talk about member changes, which you know what happens,
Let let
so
let let let
you don't
Matt
want it to happen.
let Matt let Matt finish what he was gonna say real quick. What are you saying, Matt?
Oh, Matt can definitely take on the band name situation.
I feel like it's a very simple sounding name, but I feel like a lot of thought actually went into it. I got at the time when I started the band with our founding guitarist. And even once Randall came in, we didn't have a name, and we all kind of sat there looking at each other. We're like, man, every band we've been in has been like multiple word names. There's been like, three or four words or something silly sounding, whatever, trying to fit a scene, be a little scene kid. We're like, we want something that's short, sweet, to the point, catchy, and as dumb as this might sound, we think about like crowd performance. Like, we were thinking about this way early, but we were like, we want something that's like really easily chantable, like just
Oh, that's cool.
a one word name that's really easy. It just rolls right off the tongue. And I forgot how exactly the word Seasons came up. That's how we got the one word Seasons.
Yeah, I want you guys to know something real quick and pay attention to this. I want my listeners to also pay attention. I did not ask them how they came up with their band name. I asked them what a question was. They said that question and then proceeded to answer their own question. Who has who now, motherfuckers? Who wins? Who wins? Who wins? I win. That's who wins. You see what I did? You see how I did that? You see how I did that? I fucking love it, dude. You kind of look like Tony Hawk, Matt, a little bit. While you're on the podcast, you're probably not in real life, but you kind of do a little bit.
Dude, I get all kinds of shit, like the Wish version of Machine Gun Kelly. Fucking, I don't know, man.
Do you guys agree that I won that?
You should definitely win.
All right. All right. I won. Nick's over there still yawning and picking his ear. Definitely ready to go to sleep. He is not sending any nudes tonight with his Nick's Dick Pick 69. Yeah. How do you know that? Mark knows it so well. Like, he probably looks it up.
I follow him, and I make sure I follow his page. I need to make sure he gets followers, so if he's not getting them from girls, I figure I'll just do it myself.
Yeah, 2 a.m.
You gotta support each other, right?
Feeling a little lonely at 2 a.m. You gotta support each other. I don't even have a Snapchat. Cause I fucking hate Snapchat. I don't like it. It's fucking stupid. You post one thing on Facebook, you gotta post it on all these other platforms. So I did get an Instagram. I got an Insta, which is stupid, but I do it because I was told I need to do it if I'm gonna try to do anything good in my life. So let's play. Speaking of seasons, let's go ahead and play the song name is called Killing Seasons. I love when bands are named something and then also have a name, like their band's name is this and they have a song that follows or sounds like or is their band name. So let's play Killing Seasons right now, and then we're going to play 3 a.m., then I'll let y'all motherfuckers go to bed. How's that sound?
Fuck yeah, let's do that.
Let's go. Yeah. is what I'm talking about. Dude, that's definitely my favorite song so far. Play tonight. We got one more song. That song's fucking fire. Is that one of your newer songs?
Yeah, that one came out in the last 2 months.
Okay, so Nick, you were actually able to write, be a part of the making of this song.
Yeah, that was really cool getting to be a part of making Killing Season. I helped Randall, who's our singer. He and I did a lot of the lyrics. That song's actually written as, it was written for a Friday the 13th movie that's coming out.
Uh-huh.
And we, the perspective of Jason Voorhees. So if Jason's crazy ass could write songs, what kind of lyrics would he put in it? And that's kind of the angle we took to write the lyrics. And so if you listen to the words, there's all sorts of references to like chopping people's heads off and stabbing them and all kinds of good Friday the 13th movie family fun.
Yeah, that song sounded... Now, that song to me sounds different than the first two. That song to me had more of a... It was really catchy, I thought. Like, the way the singer... The way the vocals are and the chorus, that song was fucking fire, guys. So, good job on that one. I know you guys are getting tired of looking. Hey, I want to thank you on a serious note for doing another show earlier and still making time to be on this thing with me on this podcast. So I really appreciate it. I know you guys got busy schedules, and so thank you very much for doing that. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having us on.
Absolutely, yeah. You know, and I hope you guys understand that we kind of do a little bit things different here than. We're not the normal. I don't try to be like anybody else's fucking podcast or fucking radio. Like, fuck them, you know. We do the Loud Spot shit. That's my shit. 3 a.m. We're going to play that right now. We're going to close this podcast out. Before we close it out, think of some bands during this song that you want to give some shout-outs to, maybe that you know, maybe in the Virginia area, or maybe friends you played with, things like that. I want you guys to give some shout-outs because those bands, you know, they might like it, and... It also gives my listeners a chance to listen to or to check out other bands on Facebook or Spotify or whatever they're on. So think about that. This is 3 a.m. Let's go.
Contemplating what to do, let me do with me. Think I took it way too far, and I'm stumbling drunk, getting in a car. My insecurities are hurting me. Someone please come and flirt with me. I really need a mirror that.